In the waters of baptism, Alfredo died with Christ and rose with him to new life. May he now share with him eternal glory. On the day of baptism, Alfredo received Christ. May he now enter into the house of the Lord, amidst the Christian, the faith assembly, with his dignity unstained into the presence of God. In life, Alfredo cherished the gospel of Christ. May Christ now greet him with these words of eternal life. Come, blessed of my Father. In baptism, Alfredo received the sign of the cross. May he now share in Christ's victory over sin and death.
Let us pray. O God, Almighty Father, our faith professes that your Son died and rose again. Mercifully grant that through this mystery your servant Alfredo has fallen asleep in Christ, may rejoice to rise again through him, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, God forever and ever.
Amen.
Please be seated.
There is an appointed time for everything, and a time for everything under the heavens, a time to be born and a time to die, a time to plant and a time to uproot the plant, a a time to kill, and a time to heal, a time to tear down, and a time to build, a time to weep, and a time to laugh, a time to mourn, and a time to dance, a time to scatter stones, and a time to gather them, a time to embrace, and a time to be far from embraces, a time to seek, and a time to lose, a time to keep, and a time to cast away, a time to rend, and a time to sow, a time to be silent, and a time to speak, a time to love, and a time to hate, a time of war, and a time of peace. What advantage has the worker from his toil? I have considered the task that God has appointed for the sons of men to be busied about. He has made everything appropriate to its time and has put the timeless into their hearts without man's ever discovering from beginning to end the work which God has done. The word of the Lord.
from the letter of St. Paul to brothers and sisters. And no one dies for oneself. For if we live, we live for the Lord. And if we die, we die for the Lord. So then, whether we live or die, we are the Lord's. For this is why Christ died and came to life, that he might be Lord of both the dead and the living. Why then do you judge your brother or sister? Or why do you look down on your brother or sister? For we shall all stand before the judgment seat of God. For it is written, as I live, says the Lord, every knee shall bend before me, and every tongue shall give praise to God. So then each of us shall give an account of himself to God. Word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Be with you.
And with your spirit.
A reading from the Holy Gospel according to John.
Glory to you, O Lord.
Jesus said to his disciples, do not let your hearts be troubled. You have faith in God, have faith also in me. In my Father's house, there are many dwelling places. If there were not, would I have told you that I am going to prepare a place for you? And if I go and prepare a place for you, I will come back again and take you to yourself, so that where I am, you also may be. Where I am going, you know the way. Thomas said to him, Master, we do not know where you are going. How can we know the way? Jesus said to him, I am the way and the truth and the life. No one comes to the Father except through me. The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
Please be seated. Rowella and Alma and families and friends, on behalf of Father Francis and the faith community here at Our Lady of Loreto, we want to share with you our condolences to you and your families on the passing away of your father, of your grandfather, of your friends, of your uncle. It's always hard to face the passing away of a family member, whoever that person may be. It's always hard. It's even harder when upcoming celebrations that we often have in the family is first birthday without him, his first Christmas without him, first Thanksgiving without him, many first in the life of the family without him. is even more painful when we think of it or when we face it. So again, on behalf of the faith community here at Our Lady of Loreto, we share with you our condolences. Upon learning about his passing away, we've been praying in our daily masses, and that also of the weekends. Praying not so simply for the repose of the soul of Alfredo, but also pray for all of you. Let the grace and the power of God be with you, to comfort you, to give you strength in these times of difficulty. Today we gather together to pray for Alfredo, but at some time too we all continue to pray for all of you, for the difficult road ahead of you. Again, may the grace and the consolation and the power of God and that of the Holy Spirit be with you always, to comfort you and to give you strength in days to come in his absence. We come together this morning to say our last farewell to Alfredo. But then, as we come nearer to the celebration of the Passion of the Lord, this Sunday is Palm Sunday. After that is the Mass of the Lord's Supper. And after that is Good Friday. And Holy Thursday, Saturday is the Easter Vigil. And Easter Sunday, octave of Sunday, second Sunday of Easter, Divine Mercy. My invitation for you, all of you, as you mourn for Alfredo, be faithfully to all this celebration that going to be happen. And especially the time of from Easter Sunday to the from Easter Vigil to the second Sunday of Easter. Because during those times, we listen to the scriptures and we listen to the faith of the primitive Christian community, the apostles. And we listen to that faith that we are sitting here right now, at this very moment. The faith in the real and tangible presence of Christ in the faith assembly. The faith in the real and the tangible presence of Christ in the words of the scriptures, especially that of the gospel. The faith of the real and the tangible presence of Christ in the Eucharistic species. Those readings, that of the Acts of the Apostles and also of the gospel, reading during those days of the Easter, octave of Easter, speak very loud the actions of the faith community that we come together this morning, mourning for the passing away of Alfredo, mourning for the lost of the families. But then, we also celebrate the faith of the primitive Christian community that visibly, clearly, in the gospel reading today. What Jesus said to his disciples, "Do not let your hearts be troubled. Have faith in God, have faith also in me. I will go back to my Father's house to be blessed, because in my Father's house there are many dwelling places. And as I prepare the place for you, I also come back to bring you with me so that the most important thing ever in that gospel readings, where I am, you also may be. Wherever Christ is, the body of Christ is there. So, since the time of Alfredo passing away until now, words of comfort, prayers, words of consolation continue to be upon all of you. But now we celebrate. As we come together on this morning, you see, as Alfredo entering into the church, the body of Christ, make that last official welcome him into the church, as the church did on the day of his baptism, with the holy water, with the pour of the white garment on the day of his baptism, with the Paschal candles on the day of his baptism too, he received that light of Christ, entering into the body of Christ to celebrate the real and tangible presence of Christ that continue to offering us words of comfort and consolation, and continue to offering us words of assurances of faith that the Lord is here among us, in between us, in front of us, behind us, on our left and on our right. But the Lord is here. So, my invitation to you, that as you continue to mourn and continue to pray, to seeking out for words of comfort, to seeking out his presence, because later on, he will be buried 6 feet under the earth. We no longer physically see him. But then, there's time, our faith will speak volumes when we come together as the body of Christ to celebrate the Eucharist, to celebrate the Mass, to celebrate the real and tangible presence of Christ, to celebrate the presence of Alfredo in the body of Christ, because where Christ is, Alfredo also there with us. Come and celebrate. And again, as I said before, during the time, especially during the time of the octave of Easter, from Easter Vigil until the second Sunday of Easter, Divine Mercy Sunday, we hear those words over and over and over, affirming our faith, the faith that brought us here this morning to pray for Alfredo. The faith in the resurrection of the bodies on the last day, on the faith of the resurrection of Jesus Christ. Remember him in Christ. Remembering him in the real and tangible presence of Christ, in the faith assembly, in the words, in the Eucharistic species. Remember him in the celebration of the Eucharist, because nowhere else in our prayer, nowhere else in our prayers, that we encounter this presence of the real, tangible presence of Christ in the Eucharist, the Mass. That real and tangible presence that professed by the apostles after the resurrection of Jesus Christ, by the apostolic fathers, by the patristic fathers, by generation of the faithful people, that we have that rich deposit of faith in the resurrection of Jesus Christ. Therefore, let us remembering him in Christ. God, the Almighty Father, raised Christ his Son from the dead. With confidence, we ask him to save all his people, living and dead.
For Alfredo Llanillo, who in baptism was given the pledge of eternal life, that he now be admitted to the company of the saints, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For the family and friends of our brother Alfredo Llanillo, that they may be consoled in their grief by the Lord who wept at the death of his friend Lazaro. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For our deceased relatives and friends, and for all who have helped us, that they may have the reward of their goodness, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For those who have fallen asleep in the hope of rising again, that they may see God face to face, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For all of us assembled here to worship in faith, that we may be gathered together again in God's kingdom, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer. God, our shelter and our strength, you listen in love to the cry of your people. Hear the prayers we offer for our departed brother, Alfredo Llanillo. Cleanse him from his sins and grant him fullness of redemption through Christ our Lord. Pray, brothers and sisters, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father. As we humbly present to you the sacrificial offerings, O Lord, for the salvation of your servant Alfredo, we beseech your mercy that he who did not doubt your Son to be a loving Savior may find in him a merciful Church who lives and reigns forever and ever. The Lord be with you. Lift up your hearts. Let us give thanks to the Lord our God. It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and eternal God, through Christ our Lord. In him, the hope of resurrection has dawned, that those who saddened by the certainty of dying might be consoled by the promise of immortality to come. Indeed, for your faithful Lord, life is changed, not ended. And while this earthly dwelling turns to dust, an eternal dwelling is made ready for them in heaven. And so, with angels and archangels, with thrones and dominions, and with all the hosts and powers of heaven, we sing the hymn of your glory, as without end we acclaim. Holy, Lord God of hosts, heaven and earth are full of your glory. Hosanna, Hosanna, Hosanna in the highest. Is he who in the name of the Lord. Hosanna, Hosanna, Hosanna in the highest.
Please kneel. You are indeed holy, O Lord, and all you have created rightly gives you praise. For through your Son, our Lord Jesus Christ, by the power and working of the Holy Spirit, you give life to all things and make them holy. And you never cease to gather a people to yourself, so that from the rising of the sun to its setting, a pure sacrifice may be offered to your name. Therefore, O Lord, we humbly implore you, by the same Spirit, graciously make holy these gifts we have brought to you for consecration, that they may become the body and blood of your Son, our Lord Jesus Christ, at whose command we celebrate these mysteries. On the night he was betrayed, he himself took bread, and giving you thanks, he said the blessing, broke the bread, and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, and giving you thanks, he said the blessing, and gave the chalice to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me. The mystery of faith. Therefore, O Lord, as we celebrate the memorial of the saving passion of your Son, his wondrous resurrection and ascension into heaven, and as we look forward to his second coming, we offer you in thanksgiving this holy and living sacrifice. Look, we pray upon the oblation of your church and recognizing the sacrificial victim by whose death you willed to reconcile us to yourself. Grant that we, who are nourished by the body and blood of your Son and filled with his Holy Spirit, may become one body, one spirit in Christ. May he make of us an eternal offering to you so that we may obtain an inheritance with your elect, especially with the most blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with blessed Joseph, her spouse, with your blessed apostles and glorious martyrs, with Saint Lorenzo Ruiz, St. Pedro Colunsert, and with all the saints on whose constant intercession in your presence we rely for unfailing help. May this sacrifice of our reconciliation, we pray, O Lord, advance the peace and salvation of all the world. Be pleased to confirm in faith and charity your pilgrim church on earth with your servant, Francis our Pope and Jose our Bishop, the other bishops, other clergy, and the entire people you have gained for your own. Listen graciously to the prayers of this family whom you have summoned before you. In your compassion, O merciful Father, gather to yourself all your children scattered throughout the world. Remember your servant Alfredo, whom you have called from this world to yourself. Grant that he, who was united with your Son in a death like his, may also be one with him in his resurrection, when from the earth he will raise up in the flesh those who have died and transform our lowly body after the pattern of his own glorious body. To our departed brothers and sisters too, and to all who were pleasing to you at their passing from this life, give kind admittance to your kingdom. There we hope to enjoy forever the fullness of your glory when you will wipe away every tear from our eyes. For seeing you, our God, as you are, we shall be like you for all the ages and praise you without end. Through Christ our Lord, through whom you bestow on the world all that is good. Through him and with him and in him, O God, almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever. At the Savior's command, informed by divine teaching, we dare to say, Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace nowadays, that by the help of your mercy, we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ. Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, Peace I leave you, my peace I give you, look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever. Amen. The peace of the Lord be with you always. Let us offer each other the sign of peace. Just a gentle reminder that this is the Catholic celebration. Now it's time for Holy Communion. Holy Communion is reserved for Catholics. Those who are Catholics and in good standing, you know what to do. And those who, for whatever reason, cannot receive communion now, you can come. And also those who are not of the Catholic faith, you can come forward to receive the blessing by way of crossing both of your hands on your chest. Behold the Lamb of God. Behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb. Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word, and my soul shall be healed.
Let us pray. Lord God, whose Son left us in the sacrament of his body, food for our journey, mercifully grant that, strengthened by it, our brother Alfredo may come to eternal table of Christ, who lives and reigns forever and ever. Please be seated. At this time, Rowella and also Alma are going to come forward to share with you their words of gratitude and words of gratitude to the life of their father and to thanks, words of thank you to all of you.
Hi, everybody. First, I'd like to thank everybody for coming to pay their last respects to my dad. I want to thank God for giving me my dad for my dad because he was a good dad to me and my sister. He was faithful to our mom and he was really generous to my kids. Not long ago I was visiting with my dad and he opened up to me and he said, he couldn't believe how his life turned out. He never knew he was coming to the United States. And he told me he was really blessed. God really blessed him. When my sister was about 9 or 10, she said, I remember her saying, when I grow up, I'm gonna marry Papa. My dad had a lot of redeeming qualities. But what I remember most about him is he was very thoughtful and kind. Every Christmas until his death, he remembered his brothers and sisters, and he sent money home to them for them and their families. And every time his brothers and sisters needed help, they knew they could count on him. He was very kind. Once, when the neighbors across the street moved, they left the pregnant dog behind. And my dad brought the dog home. He called her Cher, because he said she had a long face and long hair, like Sonny and Cher. And after the puppies were born, he gave them away to good homes with his co-workers. And another time, there was a stray dog that kept coming to our yard, and he befriended the dog, and the dog never left. He became our pet, and we named him Blackie. Anyway, my father knew he was blessed, so I'm thankful God gave him a long, active life. He once said, he'd never want to be connected to tubes or be in the hospital or be kept alive by a machine. And God answered his prayers because he took him while he was asleep. And I'm thankful that he didn't suffer. I just take comfort knowing that he's now with my mom. One day, we'll all be reunited.
Thank you all for coming and joining us this morning in celebrating the life of Papa. First, I want to thank the Lord for my father's life and giving my father to us and for being a loving and merciful and kind God to my father. He guided him in his life, protected him and directed him and gave him strength and many blessings and graces to accomplish his role, purpose in life, and God's will for his life. My father was a great father and faithful husband, and great and generous loving grandfather to his grandchildren. He was a good provider and he took care of us and provided for all our needs inside and outside the home. And he was a hard worker. He was a quiet man. He did not articulate verbally that he loved us, but he showed us by his action, and we know that he loved us. My father was the rock in our family. Whenever my father was with me, I felt like everything is going to be okay, and he made me feel secure, safe, and protected. What I admire so much about my dad is that he was a faithful and thoughtful husband to my mother. I remember when I was a little girl, when it was Mother's Day, he was saying to me, "What should we get your mother?" And then he took me shopping with him, and he found a beautiful plate with saying about mother. We gave that beautiful plate to my mother. He shopped for my mother and bought her nice clothes, nice gowns, fur coats, and she would wear them when they go to dinner parties. My father was a good family man. I recall when my parents bought the house in Alvarado, since it was hard for them to hire a painter, we as family painted the house inside and outside. We also helped our father with gardening in the front yard. My father taught us the value of hard work and reap rewards. My father loved the Lord. Our Lord gave him the gift of faith. He and my mother would attend Mass and Novenas together and bring us along, and would have Mass and prayers held at our home with friends in various prayer groups. The Lord gifted my father with so many things. He was great with cooking and his love for people. He had many friends. He was very organized, clean, and he had a good sense of humor. He had a green thumb. He planted vegetable garden in the backyard. We would harvest those cherry tomatoes, bitter melon, eggplant and Swiss chard, and Philippine vegetables like saluyot and kamote leaves, and cook them for lunch and dinner. He planted avocado trees in the backyard and calamansi tree and tangerines, which yielded much fruits. After harvesting them, he shared some to his neighbors and friends. He was gifted with a nice voice, which he used serving God in the choir for many years, along with his family. He welcomed choir practice in our home, and he would prepare salabat, that's ginger with hot water. The Lord gifted my father with hospitality. Both my parents welcomed relatives in our homes when they needed a place to stay. Growing up, I recall many relatives from Hawaii, Oregon, Florida, Canada, San Diego, Alaska, and Philippines stayed in our home. My father was gifted with wisdom as well. I recall one time when my sister was thinking of quitting nursing school, he told her, "It's like you're climbing a coconut tree, and when you're about to reach the top, you come back down without the coconut." He taught me and my sister his system of handling the accounts after my mother died. He knew how to keep orderly records and taught us how to handle the bills and help us a lot. He was always supportive to all our goals. He was supportive to my mother in all her business ventures when she was alive, like selling encyclopedias, jewelries, cookwares, and real estate ventures. My father was a cancer survivor and was on remission for a couple of years. With the grace of God, the cancer did not come back. In spite of many trials and pains in his life, our loving God gave him the grace to endure. During his late years, my father had chronic illness and very forgetful, but the Lord gave him the grace to live more years, and he was able to go to excursions with my sister and me, which we enjoyed very much. My sister and I tried to give him quality care. My father loved the Lord very much and devoted to God and his family. We are grateful that our merciful, loving God gave my father a peaceful death. And my father is a gift from our Lord to all of us. We love him and we will miss him very much, but we are grateful for all the great memories we had, and we will cherish them, and he will be forever in our hearts.
In our parish community, we have the prayer for the deceased. It goes like this: for those faithful departed, especially in this case, Alfredo, may his memory live on in the goodness of his family and friends who remember them. What we listen today is the love of music and the love of God in Alfredo. And we thank you, Alma, for continuing that. The love of music and the love of the Lord. Thank you for singing and playing music for Our Lady of Loreto and also St. Columban. So we remember him in your love of music, in your love of the Lord. So thank you. In the worship aid, you will find the instruction to go to the cemetery. If you want to join with them on the last mile of farewell. So again, on behalf of the faith community here, we share with you our condolences and also thank you, all of you, to be here for the family. Trusting in God, we have prayed together for Alfredo. And now we come to the last farewell. There is sadness in parting, but we take comfort in the hope that one day we shall see Alfredo again and enjoy his friendship. Although this congregation will disperse in sorrow, the mercy of God will gather us together again in the joy of his kingdom. Therefore, let us console one another in the faith of Jesus Christ. Let us now pray in silence. As we pray in silence, choir may sing the song of farewell, and also incense will be used to incense his body. As the incense rising up, purifying Alfredo and bringing Alfredo and our prayer with him to the presence of God the Most High. The response will be, receive his soul and present him to God the Most High. Receive his soul and present him to God the Most High. Saints of God, come to his aid. Hasten to meet him, angels of the Lord. Receive his soul and present him to God the Most High. May Christ who called you, take you to himself. May angels lead you to the bosom of Abraham. Receive his soul and present him to God the Most High. Eternal rest grant unto him, O Lord, and let perpetual light shine upon him. Receive his soul and present him to God the Most High. Into your hands, Father of mercies, we commend our brother Alfredo in the sure and certain hope that together with all who have died in Christ, he will rise with him on the last day. We give you thanks for the blessings which you bestowed upon Alfredo in this life. They are signs to us of your goodness and of our fellowship with the saints in Christ. Merciful Lord, turn toward us and listen to our prayers. Open the gates of paradise to your servant and help us who remain to comfort one another with assurances of faith until we all meet in Christ and are with you and with our brother forever. Through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
May Almighty God bless you, the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
In peace, let us take our brother to his place of rest.
Mercy. Let us begin. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Our brother Alfredo has gone to his rest in the peace of Christ. May the Lord now welcome him to the table of God's children in heaven. With faith and hope in eternal life, let us assist him with our prayers. Let us pray to the Lord also for ourselves. May we who mourn be reunited one day with our brother. Together, may we meet Christ Jesus when he who is our life appears in glory. We read in sacred scripture, "Come, you who are blessed by my Father, says the Lord, inherit the kingdom prepared for you from the foundation of the world." Lord Jesus Christ, by your own 3 days in the tomb, you hallowed the graves of all who believe in you, and so made the grave a sign of hope that promises resurrection even as it claims our mortal bodies. Grant that our brother may sleep here in peace until you awaken him to glory, for you are the resurrection and the life. Then he will see you face to face, and in your light will see light and know the splendor of God, for you live and reign forever and ever. Because God has chosen to call our brother Alfredo from this life to himself, we commit his body to the earth, for we are dust, and unto dust we shall return. For our brother Alfredo, let us pray to our Lord Jesus Christ, who said, "I am the resurrection and the life. Whoever believes in me shall live even in death, and whoever lives and believes in me shall never die." Lord, you consoled Martha and Mary in their distress. Draw near to us who mourn for Alfredo, and dry the tears of those who weep. We pray to the Lord, "Lord, have mercy." You wept at the grave of Lazarus, your friend. Comfort us in our sorrow. We pray to the Lord, "Lord, have mercy." You raised the dead to life. Give to our brother eternal life. We pray to the Lord. You promised paradise to the repentant thief. Bring Alfredo to the joys of heaven. We pray to the Lord. Lord, have mercy. Our brother was washed in baptism and anointed with the Holy Spirit. Give him fellowship with all your saints. We pray to the Lord. Lord, have mercy. He was nourished with your body and blood. Grant him a place at the table in your heavenly kingdom. We pray to the Lord. Lord, have mercy. Comfort us in our sorrow at the death of Alfredo. Let our faith be our consolation and eternal life our hope. We pray to the Lord. Lord, have mercy. With longing for the coming of God's kingdom, let us pray. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Almighty God, through the death of your Son on the cross, you destroyed our death. Through his rest in the tomb, you hallowed the graves of all who believe in you, and through his rising again, you restored us to eternal life. God of the living and the dead, accept our prayers for those who have died in Christ and are buried with him in the hope of rising again. Since they were true to your name on earth, let them praise you forever in the joy of heaven. We ask this through Christ our Lord. Bow your heads and pray for God's blessing. Merciful Lord, you know the anguish of the sorrowful. You are attentive to the prayers of the humble. Hear your people who cry out to you in their need and strengthen their hope in your lasting goodness. We ask this through Christ our Lord. Eternal rest grant unto him, O Lord, and let perpetual light shine upon him. May he rest in peace. Amen. May his soul and the souls of all the faithful departed, through the mercy of God, rest in peace. May the love of God and the peace of the Lord Jesus Christ bless us and console us and gently wipe every tear from our eyes. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen. Go in the peace of Christ.
And snare I have already gone. His grace brought me, he saved us far, and rest lead me home. You shall cross the barren desert, but you shall not die of thirst. You shall wander far in safety, though you do not know the way. You shall speak your words in foreign lands, and all will understand. You shall see the face of God and live. Be not afraid. I go before you always. Come, follow me, and I will give you rest. If you pass through raging waters, in the sea you shall not drown. If you walk among the burning flames, you shall not be harmed. If you stand before the elemental, it's at your side. Know that I'm with you through it all. Be not afraid. I go before you always. Come, follow me, then I will give you rest.
In a few moments, we're going to receive 25 calls of death. When you call me death, we have prepared a home for them in the city of Hollywood. Actually, we're bringing them all over to Southern California, and they always. Fly away and be at rest. Maybe you risk it.
to notice is that we'll not go home until they all unite together. Symbolic how the Lord wants to go
home. Where's the bird going?
Oh, let the Son of God enfold you with your spirit and his love. Let him fill your heart and satisfy your soul. Oh, let him things that hold on his spirit and his spirit like a dove will descend upon your life, make me whole. Jesus, oh Jesus, come and fill your life. As your hearts are filled with joy, lift your hands in sweet surrender in his name. Oh, give him all your tears and sadness. Give him all your years of pain. There you enter into life. In Jesus' name. Jesus, oh Jesus, come and build your land. Jesus, oh Jesus, come.
May its song I have to sing be
sa Diyos ang aking buhay. Ikaw at ako'y tanging handog lamang. Ikaw ni nais na ako'y isilan. Ngunit salamat dahil may buhay. Ligaya ko na ako'y isilang pagkatao ay mayroong dangal. Sinong may pag-ibig, sinong nagmamahal, kundi ang tao. Diyos ang pinagmulan, kundi ako umibig, kundi ko mang bigyang halaga ang buhay kong handog. Ang buhay kong irang sa Diyos, kundi ako nagmamahal. Sino ako? Salamat sa iyo, aking Panginoong Jesus. Ako'y inibig mo at inangking lubos. Ang tanging alay ko sa iyo, aking Ama. Ang buong buhay ko, puso't kaluluwa, hindi makayanang maipagkaloob. Mamahaling hiyas, gintumang lino ko, ang aking dalangin, o Diyos ay tanggapin. Ang tanging alay ko, nawa ay gamitin. Ito lamang Ama, wala nang iba pa, akong inihiling.